Okay. Damn, these tacos are so f***ing good. Always kind of like smush it and get everything kind of equal. You know what I'm saying? So you won't lose everything. I was gonna put the glasses up. The reason I love Taqueria Alameda, what makes it for me, is a tortilla. Welcome to Mira Mayra Land. I've always been an artist. I always tell my mom, was I born with a pencil in my hand or something like that? And she kind of says yes now. And I've been drawing since I was little, since I can remember, and entering competitions and luckily winning back home with like the National Wildlife Refuge. Kind of got my start at the Refugio County Fair. Then I came to Corpus Christi, and then I became a member of K-Space Contemporary, my second family here in Corpitos. And ever since then, working with K-Space and graduating with my Bachelor in Arts, and I went back and got my Master's in Education. I left school, and then I was like, what am I gonna do now? You know, that it sinks into your head. So now I don't have anybody telling me, oh, you need to create art. Now it's like, I have to create art. And somebody made a good point. It's like, you don't create art for others, you create art for yourself. And that's exactly what I do. I'm just very fortunate nowadays that people like my work. I've always been aware of Mexican-American art, Mexican art, but I really didn't get my start until I was in high school, and I would beg my parents to buy me the Lowrider art magazines. I don't know if people remember those. I think they still sell them. It's different times now. So we would go to Walmart and I would just buy them. I would go home, get my sketchbook out, and just kind of copy what I saw. So that's where I saw the Aztec man, the Aztec woman, the Aztec calendar, smile now, cry, smile later, the phrase. So ever since then, I just been like that. But like I said, it wasn't until about 2009 when I kind of classified myself as a Chicana artist, because I saw Cheech Marin's show at the Art Museum of South Texas for the first time. And it's so funny because when I saw that, I was like, I'm gonna become a Chicana artist. You know, kind of like I had to get that goal. I had to set a goal for myself. Then I remember telling like my boyfriend, like, you know what, when he comes back, I would love to meet him. Like, I'm gonna meet him somehow, some way. I'm gonna show him my art. I just kept throwing it out in the universe. And then when he came back, I think in about 2 years ago, he came back for another exhibition. I was working at the Art Museum of South Texas, and I got to show Cheech my work. And it was so cool because I showed him some calaverita drawings with my codex, my border, and I had him try to decipher what he says. So hopefully he at least remember, he may not remember who I was because he meets a lot of people, but I'm hoping the artwork made an impact and he remembers that little Mexican girl who made him look for the codex in the border. And he probably was like, what the hell is this girl talking about? So that's kind of like what got me into Chicano art. Diana Blunster from the Art Center asked me, why do you call yourself a Chicana artist? Because at the time, that's when I named my mural the Chicano Pop. And I did that on purpose so people can ask question, what is Chicano? So at least throwing it out there, starting a conversation of what it means. And I said, well, it's because I identify with both cultures. I'm Mexican, but I'm American. I'm Mexican-American. I am both things. Can I get my taco and show? Okay. Actually, this is taco number one. So this means a lot to me because this is the first of many tacos that I did for the Chicano Pop series. So what I like to do, I have five different versions of this taco, and basically it's the exact same design, but I change up the color. So in the purples, they each have their, it just completely changes. So that's what I said, it's pop art because it's the same image, but everything around me changes colors. And a lot of this is just, I don't want to say freehanded because I do it with the ruler, but it's all from here and all from here. I just let myself go and whatever design comes out, that's what it's gonna be. And then I got an email from Stripes Company, which I was like, woo, that's probably my biggest gig of my life, that Stripes was interested in hiring me to do mini murals for 3 store locations in Houston, Elgin, and Seguin, Texas. And I sent them the sketch, but they said it looked too stripey. What they wanted to be was more Laredo Taco Company. So then I presented my final one and they loved it. So now I show the full taco, I show my favorite taco, my favorite breakfast taco was potato, egg, and bacon with pico de gallo. So in there, on the border, on the top and bottom, is the potato and egg bacon. On the side is more of your lunch taco. It's fajita with bell peppers, and with green and red bell peppers. So that was really cool. Most people, when they see my tacos, they think like I automatically love tacos. Yes, I do. But with most art, there's a deeper meaning behind pieces. So to me, I grew up all my life going to Mexico, going to the street, eating tacos from the street. My favorite street taco is tacos de bistec with cilantro, grilled onions, aguacate, and Mexican cheese on the top. And I have to have charro beans on the side, and of course your classic Mexican Coke, not an aluminum. If I could get that Mexican Coke in the glass bottle, it just completes the meal. And then for dessert is a paleta de fresa. I have always said that, and I've joked around with you that that's gonna be my last meal. But there's proof. I have a presentation that I said that's gonna be my last meal. If I know I'm gonna die, that's it. And if I can get them from Rio Bravo, Tamaulipas, then I'm gonna die happy, whether I go to heaven or hell.